I've realized since is that it's a very painful process, but it is not destructive. It's the road to liberation. That what really happened in the 60s was that this country took just the first step toward admitting that it had been wrong all the way. And creativity goes down all the way.
From the color of the faces and Sunday songs to the hatred that raised on the youngsters on. Once upon a time in this country long ago, she knew there was something wrong. And if the song said yellow, red, black, and white, everyone rushes in the bathroom. But what about the daughter of the woman who in the house was? She and child that was hanging around. And the teacher brought up black and white. Yeah, why didn't her white mother invite them in? And when did it become a rule for the masses? That this is how they knew I don't have to ask another question. Adolescence, comfort's gone. She never thought things would ever change, but she always knew there was something wrong. Years later, she found herself Mississippi bound to help stop the legalized lynching of the swirly people, but they couldn't stop it. So they found the baton to the governor about what happened. They said, we're tired of being used as an excuse to kill black men. But the cops wouldn't let them panic. And these women, they broke up their husband, so they hauled them all off to jail. And they called in protective custody. And then Laura fell, she heard her jailers rumbling about outsiders. When she called them out and said she was from the South, they shouted, why is the nice Southern lady making trouble for the governor? She said, I guess I'm not your type of lady, and I guess I'm not your type of Southerner. But before you call me Twitter, well, it's plain as just to say, I was a child in Mississippi, but I'm ashamed of it today.
There is another America.